Welcome back to the Hardware Unboxed News Corner. Today's video is going to hopefully be a bit of a shorter one, as I reckon I'm getting a cold, which is just fantastic. And most of the topics from this week are more rumors than anything else. But before I get into the news, though, a quick reminder for those that are supporters of us through Patreon. We've recently uploaded a number of behind-the-scenes videos with more to come. The latest one involves Steve teasing a certain AMD launch along with a short tour of his studio. So check the links out for that in the description below. All right, on with the news, and this first one is pretty straightforward. Nvidia is hosting an event at Gamescom on August 20th titled GeForce Gaming Celebration. Nvidia's description of the event suggests there will be new exclusive hands-on demos of the hottest upcoming games, stage presentations from the world's biggest game developers, and some spectacular surprises. At this point, you'd think Nvidia will definitely be launching new GeForce graphics cards at this event, but of course, we don't know for sure, but surely this is the case. However, as always, temper your expectations because Nvidia could very well not launch new cards, and it certainly wouldn't be the first time they've teased events at various conferences only to rock up without any new GPU news. But with everything everyone has been hearing for months now, it sounds like this one will be the real deal. Speaking of new Nvidia cards, a photo of a new Nvidia PCB emerged this week through Baidu. Video cards are suggesting this is for the GTX 2080, though it could be named the GTX 1180, who knows, and of course the PCB could actually be for something else entirely, like a Quadro card, but it does at least look like a legitimate PCB for an upcoming unannounced product. Interesting things to note here is the lack of an SLI connector. Instead, there's an NVLink type connector at the top, which matches up with rumors suggesting Nvidia is moving to NVLink for new gaming products. There's also a relatively small pin area for the GPU, and the card's power design includes a 10-phase VRM with a 6+8-pin power connectors, which is an increase on the GTX 1080 that used just an 8-pin connector. It would be interesting to see if this is the real deal come the official launch of Nvidia's next-gen GPUs. May as well get all the next-gen GeForce rumors out of the way now. This one is a leak showing Manly Technologies, an Nvidia GPU vendor, registered an ECC certificate on July 20th that includes the words GA104 and GA104-400 in the listing, along with many other GPU names like GF104, GP104, and so forth. This is either a placeholder for the real names of these upcoming GPUs, or next-gen GeForce cards are using GA100 series GPUs, possibly referring to the codename Ampere rather than Turing. Both codenames have appeared during this rumor cycle, with Turing the more recent of the two. As of right now, the references to GA104 are still up in the listing. What has been modified are references to the GTX 2080 and GTX 2070 that appeared in a separate listing. These were probably typos anyway, as the list includes the GTX 1050 and the GTX 1060, but not the GTX 1070 and GTX 1080. The listing as of right now has removed not just the 2080 and 2070 references, but the rest of the 10 series as well, except for the GT 1030. I've seen this rumor pop up in a lot of places, but I wouldn't be taking this as a confirmation of what the new GPUs will be called. Those are still up in the air at the moment. ASUS has accidentally published a list of motherboards that use the Z390 chipset, which Intel still hasn't officially announced. The list appears to be basically ASUS's entire lineup, spanning 19 products, 5 product lines, and 3 separate form factors. I'm not going to read out every name because that would be painfully boring, but essentially there are 6 ROG Maximus boards, 4 ROG Strix boards, including a mini ITX offering, 5 boards in the Tough line, 3 in the Prime line, and a single Dragon board exclusive to China. Only the Tough and Prime lines include micro ATX boards. Nothing super surprising here, just, you know, standard refresh from Z370 to Z390. MSI has confirmed through a news post that their Z370 boards will support Intel's upcoming and yet to be officially announced 9000 series CPUs through a BIOS update. The post doesn't say what 9th-gen CPUs will be supported, so it's still unclear whether Z370 will support everything including the 8-core chips or just the Core i5 line and below, which are basically rebrands of existing 8th-gen CPUs. Still, if you have a Z370 board, it looks like you'll be able to slot in at least some 9th-gen chips without upgrading the entire platform. A leaked roadmap has suggested Intel will launch their new Coffee Lake S processors in both 6-core and 8-core variants in October. Specifically, we'll be getting the i9-9900K, i7-9700K, and i5-9600K then, with more chips scheduled for Q1 of 2019. The roadmap also suggests we'll get a Basin Falls refresh in October. In other words, we'll be getting new HEDT chips from Intel, although it only listed up to an 18-core processor at 165 watts rather than the supposed 28-core chip Intel discussed at Computex. This roadmap and document looks exactly like some of the official documents we know Intel ships to their OEM, so it's either a very good fake or it is legitimate, and I reckon this one is bang on the money. DigiTimes claims the DRAM industry will be oversupplied in 2019. Citing industry sources as always, the unreliable website suggests capacity increases at Micron and improvements at Samsung and SK Hynix as well will lead to more memory on the market. This should result in lower prices. Steve predicted way back in January that memory prices would come down in 2019, so I hope for his ego that the report is complete crap so he doesn't come and gloat about it in our Discord or Skype chats. And I know you'll message me about this part of the news corner when you watch it, Steve. I know you watch these things right till the end. Final news topic of the week, Logitech has acquired Blue Microphones, who make some quality podcasting style microphones like the Yeti and Snowball. You've probably seen streamers use them, and we've got a few as well. The deal was done for $117 million in cash and will strengthen Logitech's peripheral lineup. That's it for this week's News Corner. Hopefully I don't get any sicker in the coming days. Subscribe if you want this segment in your inbox every Friday. Consider supporting us through our Patreon to get exclusive access to behind the scenes content. And I'll catch you in the next one.